All right. You're almost ready to start launching your campaigns, and it's time to build some audiences. In this module, I'm going to show you how to create audiences within Google Ads using pixel data and YouTube. So there are a ton of great ways to use this data, and we'll walk through some of those as we take a look at the tool. So we just need to navigate over to the Audiences Manager. Then we can click the plus sign. And first, we're going to walk through website visitors. For starters, one of the easiest ways to use Google Ads is to target a specific page. So for this specific use case, let's take a look at the product page, and those product pages all contain the word product. You'll see as I type that in that it populated over here an estimate of how large that cookie pool should be. So that should be plenty large for our purposes. So we'll just say visited a product page. And then we could save this. If we wanted to, we could change the membership duration. So right now the default is 30 days. That's good for this use case. So I'll leave it as is. Let's come back and take a look at some other options. Another one that we could do is people that either visited multiple pages, people that did not visit a specific page. For instance, if you wanted to get people to a specific page and you wanted to create an audience of people that you knew had not yet been there, that could also be a way to make sure that you're not targeting converters, but typically I just like to create an audience of converters and then exclude those just to be sure. Or you could look at visitors of a page during specific dates, as well as visitors of a page with specific tags. So the tagging one is interesting because what you can do is you can create a tag and you can set it to fire for certain events, and then that allows you to create remarketing lists off of those specific events. So for instance, here we have different events that are different parts of our funnel that we can then create remarketing audiences off of to continue to move them down to the next step in the funnel. If you wanted to create a new tag, it's super easy. All you have to do is name it and then you'll get the tag, and then you can place it wherever you would want to. So we'll just call this one test, save. And then once we get the tag, we can have it fire after certain actions. You can have it fire on certain pages, however you would want that to work. We already have the global tag in place for this particular client. If you don't have it in place, you need the global tag to fire on all pages of your website, and then you can fire this specific event snippet, and that's going to be what fires in order to create the tags that you have defined. So then you could create an audience off of that. Super easy. And then likewise, we can change the membership duration of this as well. Also, if you have an app, you can create audiences off of the app. This particular client doesn't have an app, so I'm not going to show you that section, but it's super easy. You can create audiences off of people that either have engaged with your app, people that have downloaded your app, even if they haven't engaged with it, or people that have engaged in specific ways. Similarly, with YouTube, if you have a YouTube account, you can target people that viewed the video. You can target people that viewed only certain videos. You can target people that have subscribed, people that have visited the channel page, people that have actually engaged with a video, such as like liking it or adding it to a playlist or sharing it, things like that. And I really like YouTube remarketing because if there are already people watching your YouTube videos, it just makes a ton of sense to re-engage them to keep them in your funnel. Depending on your audience sizes, I love to be able to retarget specific video views because it gives you the opportunity to kind of know exactly what they're interested in. And it may also give you some indication of whether or not that they're currently in market, which would determine what content that you would deliver to them next. So there are a ton of really great options as far as YouTube remarketing goes. Let's cancel out of that. And then last but not least, there's also the option to do custom combinations. So for instance, if you wanted to create a really highly specific audience, and if you had the data, you could say, I want to target people that viewed this YouTube video and also viewed my pricing page. So there's a ton of different ways that you can create audiences and then come to the custom combination section and start to combine them together to have a really hyper-specific audience. So there you have it. There are a ton of different ways that you can create audiences within Google Ads, from targeting specific pages to pages with tags, various timeframes, app audiences, YouTube audiences, custom lists, or a combination of them all. So dig around and see what you come up with for your account.